The last few months have been spent right here at my parents' house.
So this is what it's kind of looked like.
Hey, can you guys keep it down?
All right.
Gotta pay the bill somehow.
Hi, Sean.
After our morning classes, we have the most consequential decision of the day. To work out, and it can go like this. Or it can go like this. Well, that's not ideal. Regardless, whether we end up working out immediately after our classes or we take that nap, we usually end up working on our computers.
Sometimes it's all day of nothing but this.
And this.
Go, there you go, look at you go.
Go, go.
Oh, look at you go.
We usually eat at home. Today is meal.
One of the best perks about being home is that we get to have dinner with the family pretty much every night. And sometimes we're hitting the town to find El Paso's best tacos.
Sometimes.
Not as often as we should.
We come and hang out with my mom.
So as you can tell, we've gotten into a pretty comfortable rhythm here at home.
So we started craving that feeling of adventure and needing to step outside of our comfort zone.
And we kind of did.
We bought an RV, a 1973 Dodge camper van to be exact.
Feast your eyes on our new baby.
New home on wheels, guys. Are we crazy? Possibly.
But let us walk you through our thought process. Ever since we started traveling, we've always talked about how awesome van life would be. Getting a van, converting it, and traveling all over the place. And it's something we actually planned doing after our Mexico trip.
Then the pandemic hit and basically flipped our entire plans upside down. So now we have no idea when it'll be safe to head back to Mexico and travel through Mexico. And frankly, we don't really want to wait around. So we've been playing around with the idea of possibly traveling around the US for a couple months.
State and national parks are opened up again, and the idea of traveling around, not needing a hotel, began to sound ideal.
So the search for a van began. We scoured online marketplaces and local used car dealerships to try to find a used cargo van, specifically a Ram ProMaster or a Ford Transit, but apparently those things fly off the lot as soon as they arrive. So we couldn't really find anything used that we wanted.
We even considered just buying a new one. We were that determined to get a van. And we were actually this close to just pulling the trigger and buying one and just getting a loan or whatever. And we were talking to Joanne's mom about it, and she happened to mention that they actually have a van on their lot just sitting there.
So we immediately decided to go check it out, and well, it was definitely a fixer-upper.
But
But nonetheless, we were excited.
Like we said, it was definitely a fixer-upper, but we thought if we could actually pull this off, it would be like the ultimate accomplishment. From like this rusty old thing to like a home on wheels, it would have been really cool.
Unfortunately, the problem started when we looked under the hood. My brother is a mechanic, and after looking at it, he said it was gonna be a lot of work. So, though we were not entirely discouraged, we were still a bit determined to make it work. We started looking at other options, just in case.
Then a few days later, we receive a call from Joanne's dad, who found us an RV.
An RV.
So our curious selves head over to the owner's lot and we check it out for ourselves. Can I say it was vintage. But once again, we were excited and we saw nothing but potential.
There was a lot more space than in the van, and it was in much better condition, especially under the hood. We had my brother look at it and he was pretty confident that he could get it started. So we went ahead and purchased an RV motorhome.
And a couple days later, we got the title, got the keys, and we moved the RV to Joanne's parents' place.
So, we are officially owners of a 1973 Dodge motorhome. We don't really know what the exact plan is. We just know that we want to travel as much of the US as humanly possible within the next couple of months, maybe even take it to Mexico.
Possibly. But we have to see if we can even get this thing started. Wish us luck.
See you in here working hard, Hops.
It's chump work.
That's the best flashlight holding anyone could ever do.
I gotta agree with you.
Christian hates my guts.
Slightly. It's not that bad though. Could be worse.
That's the old fuel pump. That's what we're trying to switch out right now. And in the meantime, we have Javier over here. Cleaning out a pipe.
Don't even ask me where it goes. I just do what I'm told.
So we realized it wasn't sucking in the gas, so we needed a new fuel pump. Got that at AutoZone, and now they're just about done putting it in.
There you go. It's on!
Woo! Oh man, that's exciting. We think this is the reason it's not starting. So let's hope it is.
Yep, the gas going into it. All right, that's it, it should start.
Is it ready?
I think so.
It actually sucked up gas.
Yeah. Ahí va, ready? Ahí va. Give me a grandson or a granddaughter. Twins.
This is my father, guys.
Grandpa.
You'll probably see him a couple times. He's crazy.
All right, let's see. All right.
But guys,
good job,
we have officially gotten it started. We're gonna add water. But how do you feel?
Oh my God, it feels like we're getting somewhere.
Yes, we're getting somewhere. So excited, guys.
To El Dorado.
We got any come up
for it. El Dorado.
Yeah. Hey guys, if you got any ideas for a name, just leave them in the comments.
Hell yeah.
El Dorado.
Cheers, guys. Cheers, guys.
Salud. Thank you, Lord.
Look at these men.
And our seltzers.
They're seltzers.
I don't think this is good, guys.
That was so exciting.
We got it started, guys. That was the initial goal, to get this bad boy started. Well, maybe it's a bad girl. We don't have a name yet, so maybe it's a, you know, whatever. Anyways.
We got a new battery for it. We changed out the fuel pump and the thermostat and got it started.
Got it started.
As you saw, the radiator is actually not working.
It's leaking.
So We're gonna see if we can get that replaced and fixed, and then hopefully by next video, it'll be done and we can start our build. So guys, in future videos, you can expect to see our renovations and build for the entire thing from start to finish.
I'm so excited, guys, to get started and to just kind of share the process with you guys and learn as we go, because we don't know crap about what we're doing.
Yeah, I know zero, but I'm excited.
I'm super excited.
Yeah, and actually it's gonna be a fun process just learning as we go along. If you got any tips, leave them down below. And yeah, we have a lot of plans for this.
And thankfully we have my dad, who is like the ideal handyman for this type of project. So we're very lucky that he's gonna be able to help us.
And of course, Joanne's brother, Christian, like huge help already, got the thing started. I'm just excited to learn from them.
It still feels like it's so far away, guys, but we're freaking stoked. So guys, you know the drill. If you like this video, give us a thumbs up. Oh yeah, and subscribe if you haven't already, because we have tons of fun remodel, rebuild stuff coming your way. RV life, that's gonna be our new thing.
Oh my gosh, we can say RV life.
All right guys, so we'll see you in the next one. Ciao.
Bye guys.
Bye.